how much money do we know, or should we be pulling out? Should we be pulling money out every day, every week? What's the most efficient way to do that? Well, there's a couple of ways. Depending on the type of debt tool that you have. So just specifically looking at this specific home equity line of credit with no withdrawal limits, no transaction limits. I can take as much out as I want. I can put as much as I want inside, no limitation. Now that we understand that, best time, or I should say most effective way to pull money out of the HELOC throughout the month to pay your bills is either going to be a daily, that's like truly maximizing it, more efficiently, in my opinion, 3 to 5 days. Every 3 to 5 days, money would come out of the HELOC to cover bills and expenses that cannot be paid with a credit card, right? So all of these monthly payments cannot be paid with a credit card. The $2,000, $375, $228, $216, $323, $1,000 cannot be paid with a credit card, okay? So the bills that cannot be paid with a credit card, every 3 to 5 days, I pull out a lump sum of cash back to what? The checking account that was linked to the HELOC. Your checking account continues to pay bills just like you were doing before. Rest of your income sits there in the HELOC, covers the payment of the HELOC itself. So therefore, there's no payment on the HELOC. This $12,618.78, there's no payment. My payment was my paycheck. When I make the payment to the HELOC via my paycheck, damn near all of that is what? Principal. Very little interest. Again, offsetting the interest. Hope I'm being very laser focused here this evening, because I think a lot of people are getting confused. And as you should be, because this isn't a culture most of us are used to. So you will be confused. And then there's a lot of content in the marketplace, which can be very difficult to comprehend when you're learning from 5-10 different people. So while you're doing your research, be sure to eventually narrow your viewership to a few people, maybe 5 or less. Narrow it down so you can get honed in on a few ideas that you can implement to renew your culture, your way of thinking around money to better your situation, right? So let's keep this going. We understand what's going on fully. I'm doing velocity banking on the HELOC. I'm running bills through a credit card. I'm getting cashback rewards. My cost of borrowing is zero. I actually come out ahead. I'm making money while paying off debt. Another thing that we can do to enhance the strategy here is we can come back to this card right here, this credit card, and we can say, okay, what's the culture with this? I see a lot of people doing this when I work with clients. They take the balance that's owed when they leverage a credit card on 0%. They take the balance and they divide it by the amount of months that they have zero interest, which is a noble strategy. It prevents what from occurring? It prevents you from forgetting to actually pay that bill off in time. So if you're that type of person that kind of forgets, you're like, oh shoot, I got that credit card expiring next month. These credit card companies aren't exactly notifying you when your card expires. That's part of the game that they're playing. They're betting that you're gonna forget because they gave you such a long time, 12 months, 18 months, 21 months, 24 months, 30 months, or however long it goes. They do that on purpose so you forget. Meanwhile, the interest is compounding daily, stacking, 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 stacking. Moment you forget, they now get to charge all that interest to your original balance that was damn near paid off, but you let it slip. So I can totally understand when people do this and they take the balance they owed on a 0% card, they divide it by the amount of months that they have zero interest. So in her case, roughly $375 a month is what she's paying for the next 6 months. Now, I told her, now that you're disciplined, husband and wife, very good with cash flow, you paid off a ton of debt, you've been doing velocity banking for a year, let's drop that method and let's practice efficiency with every dollar. Let's maximize our cash flow. Instead of paying $375 a month, you're just gonna pay the monthly minimum payment of that card, which is probably anywhere from roughly 1 to 2% of the balance. So it's probably gonna be like $50 a month, probably less than that, right? Let's call it 50. 375 minus 50 is 325. I can reroute $325 Back to the cash flow, ladies and gentlemen. What occurs when I do that? Well, 7,736.74 minus 325. My expenses now drop to 7,411.74. Cash flow increases by the same amount of number. 1,960.10 plus 325. Now I'm at 2,285.10. Uh-oh. We didn't even pay off debt yet. All we did was reroute cash flow. Why? It doesn't cost me anything to keep this debt. In the velocity banking world, we're constantly looking for cash flow opportunity increases plus interest savings. Usually cash flow is critical, interest savings second, balance third. So usually that's the order. Cash flow first, interest savings second, balance of the debt third. In that order is typically the case, majority of the time. $325 of principal on a debt that is charging me interest, what happens, ladies and gentlemen? I go faster. The dollars work harder for me. So now I only have $7,411.74 coming out. $2,285 stays in the HELOC. Again, I'm leaving room for error. So I went off of these numbers till about January of 2021. Income goes in, expenses come out, balance is at what? 86,98.58. December, income goes in, expenses come out, bomb, 6,738.48. January, balance is at roughly 4,778.38. If you were to take 325 times it by 4 months, right? 325 times four is 1300. So you could take 4,700 minus 1300. The actual balance should be probably somewhere around $3,400. And then when you factor in the likelihood of their income returning back to this number over a period of time, let's just say it goes up $1,000. Let's just say it goes up $500. 500 times four is $2,000. Balance is nearly paid off. So I'm betting that anywhere between January and February of 2022 is when I make my next chunk. All right, next chunk. The balance should be paid off, zeroed out. If it's not zeroed out, it's very close to zero. Here is a situation where we don't necessarily have to wait for the HELOC to hit zero before making our next chunk payment. Why, Denzel? Because since October, September of 2021, this tool, this debt, wasn't charging me any interest, although I owe money on it, although I'm paying interest, I'm offsetting it, ladies and gentlemen. So therefore, I'm incentivized to leverage this debt, zero cost, borrowing from Peter, to pay the Pauls. Paul's charging me 8.99, 5.99, 5.25, 15.43. Do you see that? Good stuff.